The security measure has been wrapped up in controversy, with strong arguments for and against its continuation. While certain communities praise the efforts due to reduced crime in their areas, there has been criticism that crime is still rising on the national level. Speaking Tuesday night on RGR's Balancing Justice, Dr. Barnett argued that evaluating the success of the states of emergency should be broader for a more accurate view.
It can't be on a parish basis because we have known that criminals are migratory, and therefore if you establish a state of emergency in one area, it may mean that they go to another area and that the criminal activities, while it will decrease in one area, may increase in another area. So that when you look at the national statistics, for instance, 2019 has not shown any improvement over 2018, and so that the so-called success has to be viewed with caution.
And Dr. Barnett has cautioned that the effectiveness of the states of emergency is under threat because of the wide-scale use.
States of emergency gives exceptional powers to the security forces, and the use of those powers on a continuous basis reduces the effectiveness of those powers because they become routine, they become people become accustomed to it, and the criminals therefore begin to operate in a manner in which they seek to circumvent the restrictions of the state of emergency.
Meanwhile, attorney at law Lambert Johnson, who was also a guest on Balancing Justice, argues that there are benefits to having security measures, but there needs to be a balance in how they are executed.
I appreciate what is being done, but the balance in the terms of where it is executed, which they have the option of doing it properly and not be, I don't want to say malicious, but being less than rigorous and in the way that they go about implementing the states of emergencies. Because one of the things I find, sometimes someone is charged with an offense. And because this person is charged with an offense, they think that, oh, let's just hold him under the state of emergency. So if it is that the concerns that I've expressed and others are ironed out and taken care of, I would support an extension.
Sasha Lee Hamilton, Frontline News.